The American television drama Route 66 was a show that premiered on CBS in 1960 and ran until 1964 with a total of 116 episodes. It was created by Herbert Leonard and Sterling Siliphant. They were both responsible for the ABC drama Naked City. Route 66 was indirectly a spin-off of Naked City. Both shows used a similar format, the difference being where the shows were set. Naked City was set in New York City, while Route 66 changed every week. Route 66 followed two young men that traveled the United States in their Chevrolet Corvette convertible. It was all about their journeys, the events that happened to them, and the consequences to those events. Todd Stiles was played by Martin Milner. He was a recent college graduate with no future prospects due to a circumstance beyond his control. George Maharis played Buzz Murdoch. He joined Todd Stiles in his travels around the country. Buzz was a longtime friend of Todd's, and he actually had worked for Todd's father. Now, the series was kind of a hybrid between episodic television, which had continuing characters and situations, and an anthology format in which each episode's weekly show was a completely different cast and story. It's kind of been dubbed a semi-anthology by trade magazines. Todd and Buzz kind of symbolized the restless part of youth that's searching for meaning in life in the 1960s. They take all sorts of crazy jobs during their journey. They work in a California vineyard. They work on a Maine lobster boat. All these jobs bring them in contact with dysfunctional families or people that were troubled that need their help. The lead characters are not always the focus of any given episode, and their backstories are revealed only in occasional references across the widely spaced episodes. The character that Maharis played, Buzz, was absent towards the end of the second season for several episodes. He had a bout of infectious hepatitis. He returned for the start of the third season, but again was absent for a number of episodes before actually leaving the show entirely midway through the third season. So that's the reason that in numerous episodes in late season 2 and in early season 3, Todd travels solo, while Buzz is said to be in the hospital with some kind of illness. Todd is seen riding Buzz a lot and also having a one-sided conversation with him. There were actually 13 episodes that he appears solo in. Buzz made his final appearance in January of 1963. He was then written out of the show without an explanation for the character leaving. He just simply stopped appearing, and he was never referenced again. Todd then gained a new traveling companion named Lincoln Case. That was played by Glenn Corbett. He plays a United States Army veteran of the Vietnam War that's just completely haunted by his past. Link was more introspective than the often extroverted Buzz, but he did have an explosive temper like Buzz did. Link, nevertheless, was a reliable companion as the duo continued their travels across the country. The show was shot on location around the country. Its producers traveled around the country with location manager Sam Manners to a wide range of locales, and they actually wrote the scripts to match the settings. The actors and the film crew would arrive sometime later. The show had very little connection with the U.S. highway that provided its name. Most of the locations were very far from the mother road that passes through only 8 states, while the series was filmed in 25 American states, plus one area out of the country in Toronto. The Mother Road is only mentioned briefly in 3 early episodes of the series, and the actual highway is even more rarely shown. Route 66 is one of the few television series to be filmed entirely on the road. The people, their accents, their livelihoods, their ethnic backgrounds, and their attitudes varied widely from one location to the next. Now, the car they drove, the Chevrolet Corvette, was as much of a star as the actors were. There are a few publicity photos that show it being black or red model. Because the series was filmed in black and white, they used light-colored cars like Horizon Blue, Cascade Green, and Fawn Beige. These colors showed up better on the black and white cameras. Now, the original working title for the show was called The Searchers. The problem with that is there was another film that was made in 1956 called The Searchers, and it was directed by John Ford and starred John Wayne. So they renamed the series. Now, the show decided to have a new theme song written by Nelson Riddle rather than pay royalties to Bobby Troup for his song Get Your Kicks on Route 66. The series was lampooned in April of 1962 in an issue of Mad. The parody was entitled Route 67. The show was on the cover of TV Guide four separate times. In 1963, an episode of the comedy show Leave It to Beaver has Eddie Haskell obtaining a job on an Alaskan fishing boat, and he kind of likens himself to the guys on Route 66. Despite all the adventure and drama, the real subject of the series was the human condition. Todd and Buzz were observers and mentors to broken-down prize fighters, rodeo clowns, sadists, surfers, hairdressers, runaway kids and orphans, and other people from all walks of life forced by circumstances to confront their demons. The guest stars included all ends of the Hollywood spectrum, all the way from Slim Pickens to Suzanne Pleshette. One of the most historically significant episodes of the series was titled Lizard's Leg, Owlet's Wing, and it featured Peter Lorre, Lon Chaney Jr., and Boris Karloff as themselves, with Boris actually donning his famous Frankenstein makeup for the first time in decades, and Lon Chaney was made up to resemble his 1941 role of Wolfman. Joey Brown and Buster Keaton also appeared together in an episode mixing comedy and drama. The show aired on Fridays from 8:30 to 9:30 Eastern Time on CBS for its entire run. The last show aired March 20th, 1964. If you haven't watched Route 66 in a while, I urge you to go back and take a look at it. It's a great show, and you'll be amazed at how easy it is to watch and how fun it is to follow these two gentlemen across the country. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll keep chasing the classics.